Hello friends, welcome to a new video in karate series. In this video I will explain how to set up the karate framework on IntelliJ IDEA. I'm going to cover three points here: how to install, how to download and install IntelliJ IDEA, how to create the Maven project using karate archetype and run the feature files, and also how to create a simple Maven project without using the karate archetype and directly adding all the dependency to the POM file. Okay, so let's go to the video. To download IntelliJ IDEA, just search for IntelliJ download and open the jetbrains.com, and you can select the community version, which is for JVM and Android development, and that is open source. Click on the download button, so it will start downloading now, and once it is downloaded you can open the file. And just select all the default options and clicking next button. And this is the destination folder. If you want, you can change that. And you can keep all the other default options and keep clicking next. And once it is done, you can click the finish button. Now you can search for IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition and open that. You can agree the privacy policy for the first time, and from here you can create a new project by clicking the new project button plus icon and choose Maven. Since we are going to create Maven project, you can choose Maven, and from this options you can select your JDK version. These are the versions available in your system, so you need to have Java installed before installing IntelliJ IDEA. So I'm going to select the JDK 11 version here. Now karate supports even the latest version, JDK 15 and JDK 16. Okay, so you can select a new version, and here you can give group ID as com.intu.karate, and the next one artifact ID, which is you can give karate archetype, and you can give the karate latest version. I'm going to give 1.0.0, and we can select the karate archetype 1.0.0, and here you can give a name for your project. So here you can see your project summary, group ID, artifact ID, version, and your project name, right? Artifact ID is nothing but the project name. And once this is done, you can click the finish button. So the project will be open now. And you can wait for scanning the files. It's indexing JDK now. You can wait for all these operations once you create a new project. So now you can see in the POM file we have only this much block, right? We have group ID, artifact ID and the properties. And once this build is complete, we can see a few more additional blocks in this POM file. Now if you scroll down, you'll be able to see all the karate dependencies are added to POM file, right? Which is com.intu, which is the we selected while creating the project. So karate gunit 5 is got added to POM file, and the version is 1.0.0, which we gave while creating the project. Also, we have this build test resources folder, Maven compiler plugin and Maven Surefire plugin. And the build is completed now. You can see build success message. And also we have a warning message in the left hand side. You can ignore this. Now, if you open this SRC test Java folder, that is the class path, you will be able to see test runners and a feature file, that is users.feature. And this is a test runner, userrunner.java, which will run the users feature, user.feature file. And this is the feature file. It's a karate test having two calls, method get and post. But these feature files are not in the Cucumber editor mode. It's not in a color mode, right? So we can install some Cucumber plugin for IntelliJ, just like we did for Eclipse ID, okay? If you click this install plugins button, you will have an option to install which is Jokin plugin, okay? But don't install that option. For that you can install Cucumber editor only. For that you can go to file, settings, and go to plugins, and you can search for Cucumber here, and you will get the plugin Cucumber for Java, and you can click the install button, so it will get installed. And once it is installed, you need to restart your IDE. For that you can click the restart button. IntelliJ will be restarted now. Now we should be able to see the feature files in the editor mode, Cucumber editor mode. Now you can see the feature files are colored mode, right? So it's installed successfully. Again, we can wait for scanning files to index. Once the Cucumber plugin is installed, you will have an option to run your feature file. When you right click the feature file, you will have an option run button. You can click that run feature, you run users.feature. So that feature file will be executed. So the script is executed and the test is passed successfully. We have two scenarios in this file. Now we can run the feature files using the other method by running the test runner. The test is passed. There are two tests. So the example test will run all the feature files in the subdirectories. Now we can run the feature by running the userrunner.java class, which will run only the user.feature file. We have karate config.js and the log XML file also present in this project. Now we can create a new project, Maven project only, without you giving the karate archetype here. For that you can again go to file, new project, and you can choose Maven. And here you can select the GDK version, and don't click the create archetype button. Instead you can go to the next page and you can give a name for your project, and you can click the finish button. So it's asking us if you want to open that project in a new window or the same window. It is opened in the same window. Now in the POM file, we have only these blocks, properties, group ID, artifact ID. And now if you want, you can add all your dependencies which are required for the karate project manually. Okay, you can take from the Maven repositories. You can take each dependencies from there, karate JUnit, karate, all the dependencies, and you can add it to this POM file. Okay, we can add the dependencies block. And let me add one dependency, which is karate gunit 4 dependency with version 1.0.0. likewise, you can add all other dependencies to this POM file, and you can try building the Maven project. Okay, so that's it guys. We will see with another feature in our next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.